it's time that we loose some things. It's time that we let some things go. And it's time that we let some shackles fall down that have been holding us captive. That's not my message, but
thank you, Jesus.
I'm going to tell you is only so long God is going to let us run from what He has called us to. There's only so many corners we can turn. There's only so much bothering people that we can do. There's only so much ignoring of the Spirit that we can do before God hears our call. And I personally don't want to be in a position where I'm not doing what God told me to do, and God is ready to pull my call. Jonah would have rather have died than to do what God said. He said, that's fucking wrong, right? Because he just figured that I'm just going to go ahead and drown and die. And if I'm dead, I don't have to go to Nineveh. I can't be dead and go to Nineveh at the same time. So I'll just assume be dead, then go there to ghost. But God help me. So they throw him overboard, all the buddy. We not going to die because of it. So they throw him overboard. And he's in the water. And a fish comes and swallows. You know, little kids' stories say that it's a whale. But the Bible says it's a fish. It wasn't distinct in what swallowed. So he's swallowed by this fish whole. Grown man swallowed by a fish whole. And he's in this fish's belly. And he says, it feels like I am. Now look at this. We sometimes, Jonah is at his lowest point in life. He is in the depths of the ocean. He is swallowed by a fish. And there is nothing that he can do. Chapter 2 says, then Jonah prayed to the Lord, his God, from the fish's belly and said, I cried out to the Lord because of my affliction, and he answered me. Out of the belly of Sheba I cried, and heard my voice. We should not have to get to the lowest point in our lives before we call on God. Some of us are so stubborn and so hard-headed and so stiff-necked that we wait till we get to the lowest point in our life before we call on God. We have to feel like we are in literal hell before we call on the name of God. It shouldn't have to get to that point where it feels like we are in hell before we call on God. God has been there the whole time waiting for you to open up your mouth. Because you were stubborn and stiff-necked, you did not want to open up your mouth and call on God. God said, I have been right here the whole time, and I watched you go through this, and I watched you go through that, and every time you thought that you could figure it out by yourself, and every time you took a step backwards instead of taking a step forward closer to me. Seventh verse says, when my soul fainted within me, I remembered the Lord. When I got to my lowest point, then I remembered God. You know, as a minister, move out the way, sit down, take a breather. Daddy's about to handle it. And Daddy came in and he took care of it. Everywhere I tried to do it by myself. But the comprehension in my mind couldn't wrap my head around what was going on in my life. But I was a man. I was going to fix it.
Thank you.
then something else happens. And we get disappointed. Because things didn't go the way we thought they should have gone. God didn't move the way you thought he should have moved. God didn't move quick enough for us. So our faith becomes a little more ready. And then we get sick. And we have to go through different things and different doctors. And we say to God, God, I thought you were here. But I'm still suffering through this. Lord, I thought that I was going to get better. But I'm not getting any better. It's not changing. But I'm not getting any better. So our faith becomes wavered in that capacity. Things in our life aren't what we expected them to be.
Come on.
The person that we fell in love with, she really isn't what she said she was going to be. You know, when he was dating, I was promised bacon and eggs and grits because we have a new thing now. But this religion. Mm-hmm. So you don't want to mess with my child. Thank you. pressing your way through. God is right there on the other side saying, I'm right here.
church.